I don't know. I'm torn as to which intro I like better. What is up, you guys? It is your host, Galadon. Town Hall 12 is upon us, just around the corner. Make sure you hit that subscribe button for the massive Gem to Max series and, of course, strategy videos and all sorts of other fun stuff. Let's go over it in about 3 minutes and then get to your questions. Town Hall 12 comes out. It is weaponized. Giga Tesla wiping out units, blowing up when it goes down. Five different levels, five different star levels to that Town Hall. The heroes are all grown up, or just about. The Warden level 30, the King and Queen almost senior citizens level 60. Now, as far as troop upgrades, it's more like what troop didn't get upgraded. The Healer and the Goblin, the only units that did not see a new level with Town Hall 12. When it comes to spells, just about the opposite is true. The only spells receiving the upgrade were the Freeze and Skeleton spell, although we saw a lot of balancing changes, which we will get to in just a moment. With those new troop upgrades came all sorts of new looks that people love and people hate, as to be expected. Form your own decision. Go back, check those videos out for sure. Now, building levels. We saw camp, lab, the regular barracks, all the storages, and the clan castle receive a new level when going from Town Hall 11 to Town Hall 12. Defenses, of course, also receiving an overhaul. Here we see all the level ones, but every single defense except the air sweeper getting a new level, putting out more damage, having more hit points, which is going to be critical because we've got offensive challenges coming. Anybody trying to hold off a defense on Town Halls 10, 11, 12 is going to need everything they can get to try to stop siege machines. Here we've got the ball buster, wall wrecker, working its way through the walls right here. The battle blimp, the air version as well. Upgradable three levels, you guys. And of course, the Electro Dragon, the most shocking addition to the Town Hall 12 update, available to Town Halls 11 and 12. Definitely electrifying attacks here and there, but you've got all sorts of other things coming to the game as well. It is going to be crazy, you guys. You've got the troops, you've got the buildings, you've got the siege machines. You also are going to see these quality of life changes we talked about. You can change your name. Lots of other stuff coming, like sleeping your clan castle, copying village layouts, and so much more. Balance changes, wall rings got better. There will be more of them for sale as well. We've got the new level of walls. We've got a larger treasury. We've got a bigger star bonus. We've got more war loot. And then, of course, you've got the buffs and the nerfs. The changes to the spells, Lightning, Freeze, and Clone all changing. And, of course, Archer Tower saw a slight nerf. Inferno Tower saw a slight buff, as did Bomb Towers. The Eagle Artillery no longer does triple damage to Golems. Healers are healing a little bit less. Miners are getting faster. Giants got stronger. Bowler's Balls got a little bit softer. They do a little bit less damage. The P.E.K.K.A.'s hit points increased. Dragons as well. Witches got buffed and nerfed. And then over at the Builder base, you've got four new wall segments. The Super P.E.K.K.A. will do less death damage, but is now going to see a few more hit points added to it to try to make up for that. Now, that is a lot to digest, I know, you guys, and over the last week of all of these crazy sneak peek videos, it was easy to lose track of one or two pieces of information. Maybe somebody missed just a minute or two in one of the videos. So I saw a lot of questions being asked, and what I've done is compiled the questions that I saw being asked repeatedly in the comment section. Now, if I didn't get to yours in the rest of this video right now, then please do leave your comment, your question down below, and I will try to get to it in a future video. If you guys noticed, I am pretty good about getting down to the comment section in every single video, despite the fact that the comment section is freaking huge right now, I'm just gonna say. But it's a good thing. I thank you for that. So let's go ahead and get into these questions. Now, we've got name changes for personal accounts, but as far as I know, not for clan names, so not happening game night. Sion wants to know about existing engineered and rushed bases. They still will be around. We will talk about that in a future episode for sure. Anshul, now this was a mistake I made. In one of the videos, I accidentally showed a level 20 Barbarian King at Town Hall 8. That was the dev build. It is not coming to the live game. James, can I tell you what server I'm no. Private server. I'm not using a private server. It's a dev build, you guys. I'm sorry. You cannot get a hold of it. my player tag right here. For those of you that are interested, my player hashtag is right there, and you can look me up anytime. Elemental Wolf God, can you use a siege machine without CC troops? Yes, but only the ground one will have any effect, as it will go through walls on the way there. How much death damage does a Giga Tesla explosion do? 1,000 hit points in the developer build. Not sure if that will be the live build. John, if you still have a free name change, you will still have that after the update drops. They won't change it, so you have to pay for the first one. Your free name change will remain free, but then you can go after that. Parker Pete, the range of the Giga Tesla. Again, in the developer build, 10 tiles. Matthew wants to know about siege machines going for a town hall if it's destroyed. They go to where the town hall was, and then they deploy. I know it's strange, but that's what happens. You do not need to max out Town Hall 11 before going to 12, but you do have to build every structure, Finesse. Neo Forever, let's go! And what is the question? Can you activate Town Hall 12 with spells? Yes, if they do damage to the town hall. Now, you donate a siege machine just like you donate any other troop, although you can hold two siege machines in your inventory at any given time. Here's the question. What does Town Hall 12 look like from the other side? Ask Adele. MRV, can you place your clan castle without the siege machine? Yes, you can. If you don't have a siege machine, your clan castle acts like it did before. Roy, the freeze spell, not dark elixir. It is staying a regular elixir spell, but strangely enough, only one housing space now. Stalker, from what I can tell, you cannot see whether your opponent has their clan castle sleeping or not. And then Samuel, the hit points of the level 13 walls, 10,000 hit points, up from 8,500 for level 12. Clash with RK, does the siege machine carry the CC troops? Yes, I think I may have already answered that one, but it does carry the CC troops, but you don't have to bring one. Shape of Music, no, I am not hacking. This is the developer build, I promise. It is a private thing from Supercell to select YouTubers. WVN Design says, seeing the new lab, screw that. I know it was not a Phillips head, it was a flathead. I know. All right, shouldn't the Electro Drag be like the Electro Whiz reset? Oh yeah, that's a good point. I asked that one of my first questions. No, it does not reset the Inferno Tower. Although at first I was thinking it should, now that I've seen how strong they are, maybe it's a good idea that they don't. Tal, the name of the outro song is The Angels Among Demons. The music that I use is by a studio called Really Slow Motion Music, and the link is down in the description. I love their stuff. Also, the music playing right now is by them. Let There Be Light is the name of this song. Lancio asks about an unusual strategy using the siege machine, and this is totally valid. This is absolutely true. Imagine the dark elixir farming by sending the siege machine directly for the dark elixir. As long as it's in the path on the way to the town hall, it's going to get there. Next question, do siege machines that are donated in the CC also defend? That would be pretty cool, but no, they don't even appear on defense. They are a non-factor when it comes to defensive stuff. Okay, a question about Peter$17. If you guys don't know who he is, make sure you go back and check out my old videos. Yes, he won Clash of Clans. No, he doesn't have his own place because he lives with me, but most of the time it's in the bathroom because he can't seem to behave himself anywhere else.
I heard that.
Next question about the siege machines. What is the space? I believe the space that they take up as far as like Eagle Artillery activation is only the number of CC troops that are inside, but that is something I need to go back and test and verify. I wonder, does it even make any sense to send out an empty one? You're going to lose those CC troops, but you will get a device to get through walls. So again, unusual strategies that might just work. You never know. Ali asking about the relationship between spells and siege machines. Well, they're not talking to each other. And what I mean is siege machines cannot be affected by spells, but the troops inside said siege machines, once deployed, can be affected by spells like Heal, Haste, Rage, and Clone. Thank you guys so much for the kind comments. Keep those suggestions coming. I've got lots of videos coming after the update, strategy to gemming and everything else in between. Have a fantastic rest of your day. Enjoy it. Be kind to other people. Love one another. Subscribe. And of course, come back again tomorrow for more Full Attacks. Full Attacks. More Full Attacks. Hoo! Full Attacks. Hee hee!
Anton, are you quite all right, man? Should I call someone? Like, life alert or something? A psychiatrist?